This time of year, it's not uncommon for young adults to complain of fatigue, fever, and sore throat. They might have the flu, but they might not. Once again, here's Lorraine Cacciola with a look at how those symptoms could be a sign that something serious is affecting your child's health.
A game of ping pong caps off this day in the Miller household, a time for these teens to burn off some of that excess energy that comes with youth. But for 16-year-old Morgan, that energy level wasn't always available. 2 years ago, this cheerleader didn't have much reason to cheer, and mom and dad had every reason to be concerned.
It took us a while to figure out what the problem was, because initially she had a lot of the same symptoms that you would have when you have allergies and you tend to be stopped up and nasal a lot, because she has that.
I had headaches, I felt achy, I had like stuffy nose and a cough.
It wasn't long before the symptoms went from bad to worse.
And I just remember, like, I don't feel like getting up, I don't feel like doing anything, I can't even lift my arms. I was just really tired.
When she was walking up the staircase to her bedroom, she would get to the top of the staircase and she just lay down.
A trip to the doctor revealed it wasn't allergies, a cold, or even the flu. Morgan had mononucleosis, or mono for short, an infection usually caused by exposure to a virus known as the Epstein-Barr virus. Symptoms of mono can include constant fatigue, fever, sore throat, swollen lymph nodes, headaches, abdominal pain, and in severe cases, an enlarged spleen.
It's sort of difficult to get, actually, compared to things like the cold. And that's why you think of it as the kissing disease, what most people say in college. And a lot of times it does take sort of close contact, exchange of saliva, that sort of thing, to transmit the infection. The other things that you might share saliva without thinking about it would certainly include eating after someone, drinking after someone.
So I started thinking, who has she been around? How did she get mono? And at the time she didn't have a boyfriend, so she probably drank after someone. Because she's a cheerleader, and she was around a lot of different cheerleaders, and they pass drinks, they pass food back and forth. They sit at a lunch table, and they share each other's food.
The prescription for Morgan? Pretty simple.
The occasional Tylenol or Motrin can help, certainly getting enough fluids. And then the main thing is to rest.
The more you push yourself and the more you try to get back to normal, you're going to get worse and worse. So you just need to, like, take a break from everything and give yourself time to recuperate.
Easier said than done for a teen on the go. That's why family support is such a big factor in getting a child on the road to recovery.
Just to let them know it's going to pass, it's going to get better. Every day, every week, you're going to feel stronger, you're going to feel better, and it really will pass, and you'll be okay.
And that's something to cheer about. For Smart Medicine, I'm Lorraine Cacciola.